di bumi. Dan I would like to welcome Matthias Galber. Thank you so much. You are the winner, the greenest person on the planet award in 2008. And you're not from Malaysia, but you've been here for 5 years. You're from Lippe in Germany.
Yes,
right?
I'd like
to start from there because it seems to be the inspiration behind your drive to be green. And when I say drive to be green, it's the same thing for the award. Mm. Recycling alone is not enough.
No.
With climate change and the whole stuff of carbon footprints and all, you need to do more than that. And the award and you fit together. And thank God, especially in this Ramadan month, you are here in Malaysia instead of being in any other country in the world.
Yes.
So can you give us a short story from Lippe to being the greenest man on the planet? And how come you're here in Malaysia? Yes. We are blessed.
Yes. Thank you very much for the kind introduction. Actually, those are my roots, my little village in Germany, my kampung. And it is a real kampung. It's only got 500 inhabitants. So I used to know everyone in the little village. And when I came home from school, I used to play out there in the natural environment, the trees. And around my village, we had loads of trees. And even the ways how the trees were managed was in a very common, sustainable manner. Actually, the trees and the forest were owned by the village community. And the village community was maintaining it, even harvesting it, and then regrowing it in a natural, sustainable manner. So my connection with the environment came about when I was a kampung boy in Germany. And I always had this feeling that I wanted to do something good for the environment. Even though my father was thinking, hey, you can't earn money with doing something for the environment. And he was kind of warning me, you know, get a proper job. I was already saying as a young boy, hey, I want to turn my life into a contribution for this planet and hopefully as well serve the human race by doing something good for this planet. So that then brought me to studying chemistry. I thought, hey, that's something, if I understand a little bit of chemistry, pollution, then I can do something good for the environment. Then I moved to the UK. I did a master in environmental science. I started working with businesses on helping them to reduce their environmental impact. And at the same time, try and give them business benefits. Because on this planet, you know, there's always the question, what's in it for us? What's in it for business? What's in it for the country?
If I turn that around, your father is not alone in that. Even now, even young people now, they won't say that, I would like to save the planet. I would like to be environmental friendly. But I want to earn a living. I want to have a career. I want to go after wealth.
Yes.
But in your lifestyle, It doesn't mean that you are a recluse somewhere, you know, hibernating in a cave, living. Somebody asked me from inside the control room is now, is this the guy who lives, you know, somewhere don't have, even have a house?
Yeah.
People still have that perception
that
you're green, you will not, you will be anti-modernism. You'll be against the pursuit of wealth, but you have proven them wrong.
Yeah, I'm a global village, let's say green man, and I have even, I started a green business, an environmental training and consulting business, and I sold it to a listing UK engineering company. So even with this, you can earn a decent living or you can even create wealth. But for me, it was wealth that I returned back again into a bigger game, into a bigger game of making even more environmental benefit. I